Last night, a decisive Game 1 victory in the playoffs against the St. Louis Blues, the defending Stanley Cup champions, no less. For more on this, we're joined by the Reach himself, Dan Riccio from Sportsnet 650. Dan, welcome. First of all, we don't have much time. We've got a lot to talk about here. Let's get into Bo, because Bo Horvat doing what a captain does best, two goals and really leading the team to victory last night.
Man, it's the kind of performance that you really love to see from your captain in a big playoff game, you know? Bo Horvat just being named the captain this year, and he put the team on his shoulders last night, scoring the early goal to get the good vibes going on the power play. And then, you know, with St. Louis, after the Canucks went up 3-2 in the third, you knew that St. Louis was going to really try and push back. And Bo just, you know, completely undressing the defenseman, scoring a big goal, and putting a Canucks young team at ease in the third period was huge.
Yeah, I like that. The special teams were good, too, with the PK and the power play. Let's talk Jacob Markstrom. I know when we spoke yesterday, I was mentioning, is there a little bit of concern about him letting in some of those goals against the Wild? But he was on fire last night.
Yeah, he had some moves that were making me feel like I might pull my groin just watching him.
Right.
It was pretty fantastic. He had some sorcery going, and that's what the Canucks needed. You know, he wasn't great in Game 4 against the Minnesota Wild. His teammates bailed him out. But last night, especially in the third period, he really locked the door down. And you can tell his movements, the way he tracks the puck, he's calm in the net. That's when Jacob Markstrom is his best. And that's that save that I think we were all kind of like, cringing just how he made that save.
He was definitely a wizard behind the pipes there, between the pipes. Also, I mean, it's easy to keep on the praise for the team, but let's look at some things that they may need to work on as we look ahead to game 2 on Friday.
Yeah, well, there's one big thing, and for me, they scored a lot on the power play. They had 3 power play goals last night. 5-on-5, St. Louis got better as the game went on. And that's where the Canucks are really going to have to improve as the series goes along. They're not going to get as many power plays, and St. Louis is going to shore up their penalty kill as well. You got to look at the big three, Elias Pettersson, JT Miller, and Brock Besser. At 5-on-5, they got to have more success because St. Louis was doing pretty well at shutting them down last night away from the power play. That line's got to be better moving forward.
All right, and it was a night full of emotions as well. I'm a Richmond guy myself, so it was really cool to see Troy Stetcher get the game winner there and do a nice little salute to his late father.
Yeah, it was. And, you know, his father passed away on Father's Day. Devastating. Troy's talked about it quite a bit. But what a goal it was. Put the team up. The tribute. Everybody knew exactly what Troy was pointing to after he scored the goal. And just a perfect way to bring the Canucks back into the playoff hockey with a local boy getting the winner.
This is shaping up to be a great series.
Yeah, it's going to be a lot of fun. I mean, it's only going to get tougher from here. Yeah. You're going to get the pushback now from the champs, but I think the Canucks are up for it.
All right, Dan, we appreciate your insight, and hopefully we can connect as the series goes on. Thanks so much.
Absolutely. Thanks.
All right. You take care, and we'll be watching the Canucks an early start Friday, 3:30, and that's Sportsnet 650's Dan Riccio coming up at Entertainment.